Hello my dear friends, in this video we will going to learn to calculate the entropy generation, that means a total entropy generation by a given situation. What is the situation? Situation is that water in piston cylinder arrangement. So there is a piston cylinder arrangement. So there is a piston and cylinder arrangement. So this is your piston cylinder arrangement. This is your piston cylinder arrangement. So this is your cylinder, right? So this is your cylinder and this is your piston. There is a piston. Okay, so this is your piston cylinder arrangement. Okay, now shown in figure is at 1 megapascal and 500 degree centigrade. There are two stoves, a lower one at 1 meter cube. That means there is a two stove. The one stove is like that. There is a one stove and there is another stove. There are two stoves, that is a lower one and a upper one, which is in this side. Upper one, which is in this side, this is your upper one. There are two piston stops, lower one and upper one, right? And there is a system is water, that means there is a water, system is water, as shown in figure below, is at 1 megapascal and 500 degrees centigrade. So what is the system? System is water, right? And initially state one is what? P1 1 megapascal, and what is the T1? T1 is 500 degrees centigrade, right? So this is our state first. Now there are two stop, one is the lower one of a volume. If this is our stop, so this is our volume, this is the volume 1 meter cube, and the upper one with the maximum value of 3 meter cube. So this is your maximum volume 3 meter cube, and this is your lower volume with 1 meter cube. Now the piston is loaded with a mass and outside atmosphere. So this is your piston, this is your piston, so your piston with the atmospheric condition, against atmospheric condition and the mass of the piston. So so the outside condition, so what is given, what is the information about this? The information is that what is the given outside, the outside condition is fixed. That means what is the mass of the piston and what is the atmospheric pressure of the surrounding. So throughout when the piston will move down from upper stop to lower stop, the external condition will fix. That means the external condition doesn't change. That means what is the weight of the piston and what is the outside condition doesn't change. So it will move. So it will move along a equilibrium pressure. Why? Because the outside pressure doesn't change. Now, so the piston loaded with a mass and outside atmospheric pressure such that it floats when the pressure is 500 kilopascal. So when the pressure is reduced, up to 500 megapascal, so when pressure inside the system is reduced to 500 kilopascal, so at this condition piston start to float. That means the loaded mass outside such that the piston will float What is the floats? Piston will floats. What is the meaning? It just lose the upper stop. So at the floats, it start to move. It starts to move. So when it start to move, so at during which pressure? During pressure 1 megapascal inside pressure to 500 megapascal, 500 kilopascal, the pressure will reduce. So the piston will lose its contact. So when the piston is lose its contact, so the piston will just start to move. That means during pressure 1 megapascal to 500 kilopascal, the system have fixed volume. That means during the process 1 megapascal to 500 kilopascal, the piston is just lose the contact. So the what is the system volume is the same. So during this process volume is constant, right? So pressure will reduce from 1 megapascal to 500 kilopascal, the volume is fixed. Now, okay, so the stop is now cooled. This system is now cooled up to 100 degree centigrade. So this is your final condition. This is your final condition. That means what is the final condition? What is the final state? The final state is 100 degree centigrade. So when it is, how it is cooled? So you just put a thermal reservoir of surrounding. What is the surrounding temperature? T infinite. Right, surrounding temperature is given. Surrounding temperature is given 20 degree centigrade. So T infinite is given 20 degree centigrade. Okay, and this system is now cooled up to 100 degree centigrade. So when the system is now cooled, so it must be reject heat from the system to surrounding. It must be reject heat from system to surrounding. Heat rejection. So it must be reject heat from the system to surrounding. So its final temperature, when the heat will reject to the system 20 degree, the final system is 100 degree and now it stop. That means it final temperature is 100 degree centigrade. So the final state of the system is 100 degree centigrade during the heat rejection. So find the total entropy. This is your total, mind it, the total entropy. This is your total entropy generation. Total generation. This is your total generation, mind it. So what is that? So we will discuss, continue. So this is our situation. Now, what is that? So at pressure P1, 1 megapascal and temperature T1. So first, in such a question, this is our system. This is our system. So first, you calculate number first. First you calculate what is the mass. Why? Because this is a closed system. See, only heat will transfer, no mass transfer. So throughout the movement of the piston, the mass is fixed. So what is the mass of the system? So for the mass of the system, we know that mass of the system is what? Volume of the system divided by specific volume. So volume of the system divided by specific volume. So from these two data, because it is a simple compressible substance, so from this data, we have a specific volume V1. So from table, we have a specific volume, and this is in the form of water. So VF fluid one you have, so and you have initial volume, that is a maximum volume. Volume, what is that? 3 meter cube. So these two this is given, and this data will calculated will be found on steam table. So this is the specific volume of the fluid, saturated fluid. This is the specific volume of saturated liquid. This is the specific volume of saturated liquid at which condition? 1 MPa and 500 bar. So you have a mass of the system. So this the mass of the system you have. So you have a mass of the system, right? So now when heat is transferred from the system, when the heat is transferred from the system, the piston will start coming down. The piston will start coming down. Then will it hit the stop? The question, first question in our mind, that if we start cooling of the system, that means if you reject the heat from the system to the surrounding, and system will reach at 100 degrees centigrade, so whether it will hit the stop or not. So the question, the first question is that when the system heat transfer up to 100 degrees centigrade, so at this condition piston will hit the lower stop. This is the question mark. Piston will hit the lower stop. See why? Because when the piston will hit the stop, once the piston will hit the stop at 100 degree centigrade temperature of the system, after that the volume will not change further. When the piston lying on this stops, so the piston, if the piston will hit the stop at 100 degree centigrade, after that the volume is constant. Let's check. See, but it start moving when it is moving, when it is moving, it is moving at start to move at this equilibrium pressure. What is that? 500 kilopascal. So till the pressure becomes 500 kilopascal, it will not start to move. That means it start to move at 500 kilopascal. So till this 500 kilopascal, that means 1 MPa to 500 kilopascal, piston will, so till the pressure becomes 500 kilopascal, this is not start to move. That means if you draw a PV diagram, pressure versus volume diagram. So this is point number one. It is given, and how much the pressure at that point? The pressure is 1 MPa. The pressure is 1 MPa. Now if we reject heat from the system to the surrounding, its pressure will reduce up to 500 kilopascal, and up to 500 kilopascal the piston doesn't move. So till 500 kilopascal piston doesn't move, just it's float. That means when it will reaches to 500 kilopascal, that means when it is reached to 500 kilopascal, till that the volume is constant. Let's suppose this is your 2. Let's suppose this is 2. Now, hence, when the pressure drop from 1 megapascal to 500 kilopascal, the volume remains constant, and then its pressure becomes 5 kilopascal, then it start to move with equilibrium pressure. Then when it is move at, when it is reach at 500 kilopascal, when it is reached at 500 kilopascal, again will heat will extract. So when the, so when heat will extracted from the system to the surrounding beyond 500 kilopascal, after 500 kilopascal, the pressure doesn't change. Why? Because pressure doesn't change, because the resistance pressure doesn't change. That is atmospheric condition, and the weight of the piston doesn't change. So the movement of the piston after 500 kilopascal, that means a movement of the piston till after 500 kilopascal, it is reached 500 kilopascal. So up to this, so 1 to 2, what is 1 to 2? See very carefully. 1 to 2, just it's lose the contact. Just it lose the contact of upper stop. Upper stop. Right? Now, once it is reached at 500 kilopascal, again further we extract a heat, so it's move at equilibrium pressure, but the volume will decrease. Now why? Because it's further will move, so the volume will decrease, right? So let's suppose 3. Now when the it's start to move, when now will it hit the stop? At this pressure will hit the stop, because when it hits the lower stop, the further volume will does not change. So let's check for that, what is your volume, specific volume 2. This is your V2 by M, and if you calculate V2 by M, this is your value. You have V2, you have M, and P2 you have. P2 is what? Just when reached. Just that means let pressure at which the piston just reach the lower stops. At what pressure? 500, let's suppose, kilopascal. Now, at this pressure, what is the temperature? Why? Because you have a specific volume. You have P2, so you have T. And at this time, that this pressure, when it reaches at 500 kilopascal, when it reaches at 500 kilopascal, then its temperature is 151.83, which is always greater than 100 degrees centigrade. This is a final temperature. Final temperature. So when the piston, when the system is at 100 degrees centigrade, then it touch the stop. But at this pressure, the system is temperature is 150. So finally, piston will not hit the lower stop, because the system temperature is more than 100 degrees centigrade. Why? Because at this temperature, the piston will hit the stop at this temperature, but at 500 kilopascal, piston doesn't hit the stop. So why? Because piston will not hit the lower stop because the system temperature is more than 100 degrees. So it not hot. Now, so it not heat source. So we will further extract a heat. So up to this much we will further extract the heat. So at this point, let's suppose it hit the stop. So at point three, that means if piston will falling down with equilibrium pressure, but equilibrium pressure, so if this pressure, the temperature is 151, so it will not hit the stop. Now further you extract a heat, so at this pressure the temperature will fallen down, and when the temperature is fall, when the temperature, if this equation, because continuously heat is rejected, so when it's, that means at this temperature piston will doesn't hit the stop. So let's suppose we will further cooling, will further extracting a heat, let's suppose we will further extracting a heat, and let's suppose it will hit the stop, but hit the stop at 0.4. So this is at, when it hit the stop, so at a 0.4 it hit the stop, right? It hit the stop. Now when this is a reduced temperature, but when it is hit the stop, again you extract a heat up to 100. Why? Because your temperature is 150 degree centigrade. So at 150 degree centigrade the piston will doesn't hit the stop. Why? Because when the piston will hit the stop, at that condition the temperature is 100 degree centigrade, but your temperature is 151 degree centigrade. So at this temperature the piston will doesn't hit the stop. So so again will extract a heat, so its temperature will reduce. So temperature will reduce, again piston will fallen down. So again will piston fallen down. Let's suppose the piston is at this much height. When the 151 degree centigrade. 151 degree centigrade. So let's suppose at this point the temperature is 151 degree centigrade, right? Now that means the piston doesn't hit the stop, but the pressure throughout constant up to when it is hit the stop. जब तक ये प्रेशर कांस्टेंट रहेगा तब तक ये लोअर स्टॉप को ये टच ना कर दे. सो 115 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड पे ये पिस्टन लोअर स्टॉप को टच नहीं कर रहा है. दैट मींस अप टू 151 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड पिस्टन विल डजंट हिट द स्टॉप. नाउ वी फर्दर कंटिन्यूअस एक्सट्रैक्ट द हीट, सो इट्स टेम्परेचर विल रिड्यूस. नाउ वंस इट रीचेज टेम्परेचर विल रिड्यूस, so it's suppose 140, 130, 120. Now after just then, let's suppose the temperature is as much as low, that means at this temperature less than this, so it will hit the stop. So now when it will hit the stop, now again you extract a heat up to 100 degree centigrade, up to 100 degree centigrade. So from 4 point is the hit the stop, again you extract the heat. Why? Because the final temperature is 100 degree centigrade. So at this condition the piston doesn't move further. So the volume again constant. So 4 to 5. So 4 to 5, what is the 4 to 5? 4 to 5 at a constant volume. So 4 to 5 is the process on which piston doesn't move further because it hit the stops. Right? So this is your PV diagram. Now find the total generation. So in this process, what is that? Find the total entropy generation. So total entropy generation. Total entropy generation. Total entropy generation, that means to find total entropy generation. So for finding the total entropy generation, you find heat transfer. For finding the heat transfer, you apply first law. This is your layout. So first law thermodynamics, what is that? First law of TD. Why? Because we calculate heat transfer. This is your Q 1 to what? 1 to 5. Process 1 to 5 is equal to M U5 minus U1 plus W1 to 5. So you have M, you have U1, you have U1. Why? Because from this table you have U1. From this table you have U1. You have U1 and U5. That means what is your U5? What is your U5? The U5 from this table, from the table, U5 is from this table. That means 5 is the final condition. So what is the final condition? You have T2. You have, so what is U5? So you have initial condition P1 and T1. So from this, you have U1. Final condition is that you have T5, you have T5 and you have U5. Why? How U5 you calculated? You have calculated that what is your volume, that means minimum volume, it will touch the stop divided by mass. So you have U5. So from U T5 and U5, you have U5 from the table. From table. So this one, and what is the W1 to 2? W1 to 5. So W1 to 5. Why? Because W1 to 5 is equal to W1 to 2 plus W2 to 3 plus W3 to 4 plus W4 to 5. So 1 to 2, 0. Why? Because volume constant. And 1 to 1 to 2 and 2 to 3, 2 to 5, there is a volume, pressure is fixed. What is the pressure? P equilibrium into what is that? V final. V final. What is the final volume? Final volume is 4. That means V minimum. This is your V minimum. What is the maximum? Why? Because this is a maximum volume. This is your maximum volume. V max, and this is V minimum, right? So V max, V minimum by into V max into V max. You have V minimum, you have V max, put the value. So if you calculate all the thing, Q1 to 5 is equal to, what is the mass? You calculate mass to mass value. You have mass. You have mass. You have all this value. You have mass. You have U5. You have U1. You have this P equilibrium. What is the P equilibrium? 500 kilopascal. So you calculate, what is that? You calculate heat transfer. So your heat transfer is, your heat transfer is 26677.5 joule. This is your heat transfer, kilojoule, right? Now if you calculate heat transfer, so from a second law, what is that? S generation plus Q1 to 5 by temperature is equal to MS5 minus S1. So you have S5 steam table, you have S1, you have mass, you have Q15. So what is the value here? What is put the value here? See, what is put? So what is the T? So T for that, it depends, very important, it depends on what you want to find out. If you want to find out the entropy generation only due to internal reversibility, so if you find out the due to internal reversibility, if you S generation at internal reversibility, so you put temperature of the system. But if you find net or total entropy generation, so always put surrounding temperature. This is keep in mind. If you find internal entropy, that means entropy generation by the system, so put the entropy generation, so put the temperature T system. If you put the temperature T system, that means 100 degree centigrade. If you put the temperature is 100 degree centigrade, so you calculate this internal generation. But if you find the total generation, you put a temperature surrounding. Only put a, so there is a two value. T is 100 degree centigrade and T is 20 degree centigrade. So if you put 100 degree centigrade, so this is your internal generation. That means this is a system generation. This is generation for system internally. But if you put 20 degree, this is total. So if you find the total generation, your net generation, always put surrounding temperature, yeah, immediate surrounding temperature. And if you find the system generation, what is the heat entropy generation by the system, so always put system temperature. So here we can, in the question, ask that what is the total generation, so put surrounding temperature. So for total yeah net entropy generation, for that T always is the T of surrounding, yeah, T infinite, what is that? 20 degree centigrade. So, and this is always in Kelvin. So 20 plus 273. So what is that? M, you have S5, you have S1, you have M, plus is equal to, this is a system entropy. So why? Because we know that, this is already know that, we know that, we know that, what is that? This is a closed system. So for the closed system, what is that? What is that? Qk by Tk plus S generation is equal to delta S of a system. There is only one way to transfer heat. So this is Q, and what is the temperature? Temperature is infinite. Why? Because you find, so this is your heat generation total, if you put this one, is equal to, what is the system entropy? M S5 minus S1. So you have S5 from the steam table, from the water table, you have S1 from water table, you have Q, you have T infinity, so you have S generation total is what? 26.27 kilojoule per kg. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.